President Biden announced via a letter to congressional Democrats on Monday that he, of course, is not dropping out of the presidential race. We need to end the talk of replacing him. We need to come together and focus on our common goal of defeating Donald Trump in November. Now, to be honest, even though I am one of those Democrats who thinks that Biden should step down, my opinion on it has not changed. However, I will say that it was a very well-written letter. It was very forceful. And let me just read you a couple lines out of it. I want you to know that despite all the speculation in the press and elsewhere, I am firmly committed to staying in this race, to running this race to the end, and to beating Donald Trump. I can respond to all of this by saying clearly and unequivocally, I wouldn't be running again if I did not absolutely believe I was the best person to beat Donald Trump in 2024. The question of how to move forward has been well aired for over a week now, and it's time for it to end. We have one job, and that is to beat Donald Trump. We have 42 days to the Democratic convention, 119 days to the general election. Any weakening of resolve or lack of clarity about the task ahead only helps Trump and hurts us. It's a good message. It's a powerful message. But I'm gonna have to fact check it, right? It's unpleasant. A lot of folks don't like when I do that, but I'm gonna do it because it's my job to give you the truth, even if you don't want to hear the truth. President Biden, in the excerpt that I just read, explicitly said that he is the best person to beat Donald Trump. Polls released last week, including internal polls from the Democratic National Committee itself, show that that is not true. President Biden does not beat Donald Trump in the polls. If the election were held today, Donald Trump would win with well over 300 Electoral College votes. He would not only be pulling in the Electoral College, but he would also easily win the popular vote. Okay? That is the sad reality in which we live right at this moment. The polls also show that pretty much all the other Democrats also do lose to Donald Trump, but some of them do not lose as badly to Donald Trump. So even among the other Democrats that lose to Trump, they still perform better than Biden. As I mentioned in a segment last week, those polls showed there's only one Democrat that was, you know, polled that would beat Trump, and that is Michelle Obama, who, of course, has never expressed any interest in ever running for president. But we have to deal with those facts, and we also have to deal with the reality. There is no amount of talking, there is no amount of, you know, Democrats on Capitol Hill telling Biden to drop out that is going to actually force him to drop out. That decision is his. And if he doesn't make that decision to drop out, we are stuck with this. At that point, we unfortunately do have to put our concerns aside and go with it. Okay? If that's all we got, it's all we got. Because what's waiting on that other side with Donald Trump, the Republicans, Project 2025, and all of that, every bit of that is far more terrifying and far worse for the future of this country than President Biden would be. And if President Biden wins re-election and doesn't make it and we get President Kamala Harris, I'm okay with that. Like, that is not going to bother me. I would also not be bothered if President Biden did come out and say, listen, I'm not going to do it. Sorry, I know I said I wasn't going to drop out, but I've made the decision to drop out. And let me tell you something else. I actually have a way he could do that and save face. Instead of saying, I simply cannot continue on in this race with my capacity, what he should do is say, listen, I've made a decision that would hurt me so badly politically, but I'm going to make the decision anyway. And because I know how bad it's going to hurt me, I'm going to drop out of the race and let another Democrat come in. And that decision he should make, and he should do it, is to pardon his son, Hunter Biden. So if he were to pardon Hunter Biden right now, obviously that's going to hurt him, right? It's his son. He loves his son. He's in a position to help him. He should help him. But knowing that it would hurt him politically, but knowing he needs to do it because it's his family, he should do it, then drop out of the race. Still keep being president, right? I'm not asking him to resign. But that way you save your son, you save the Democratic Party, everybody goes home happy. That is the way he could do it. That is my plan, you know, the idea I've concocted. So Biden, if you're watching, anybody in the White House, that's a good out for you. You know, Don't blame it on the debate performance. Don't blame it on anything else, the polls, none of that. Just say, listen, I'm going to do something that I know would probably cost me the election, so I'm going to drop out of the race and then do the thing. So there you have it. If you are looking for an out, I just gave you a pretty good one. Well, folks, we have crossed that 1 million subscriber milestone, but rest assured, we are just getting started here at Ring of Fire. So if you're not already, please do subscribe to the channel and make sure to like, share, and comment on the videos.